Hi guys, we've already seen accuracy, precision, and recall as measures of a machine learning model performance. In this video, I'll explain what F1 score is, why is it required when we already have precision and recall which do a fairly good job in evaluating a machine learning model. There is a famous precision recall trade-off, and I'll explain it using a simple example. Say suppose we have a pond of fish and we know the total number of fishes within. Our goal is to build a model that catches red fishes. In the first model that I make, it consists of two fishing nets which have baits containing food which my red fishes like. What do we observe? We observe that we end up capturing two red fishes, which is what we desired. Precision is, out of all the samples that the classifier classified as positive, what portion of it were actually correct? The following test that we have performed shows great precision. That means out of the two red fishes that we have caught, both of them are red. But if you look carefully, there were many more red fishes in my pond. So we missed out on 5 red fishes which should have been caught by my classifier. So my precision was really high here, but my recall was less. So what I do, I make a model that increases recall now. In order to do that, I make a bigger fish net, I change the bait which is now liked by all the fishes, and I capture a lot of fishes now using the new bait. And just for a recap, recall is out of all the positive samples, what portion did my classifier pick up. Now if you see in this diagram carefully, say for example approximately if there are 8 fishes, out of 8 I am able to capture 6 red fishes, which is doing a good job. Now the problem with this model now is I am capturing a lot of blue fishes in order to incorporate large amount of red fishes. So my precision although is high, but my recall is very low. My recall is high, but my precision is very low. So this is the fundamental trade-off between precision and recall. In our model with high precision, most or all of the fishes were caught were red, it had a low recall. But if we design a model with high recall, that is we caught most of the red fishes, we had a low precision, we also caught a lot of blue fishes. Can we combine precision and recall to have an overall score which depicts how well our model is performing? In comes my F1 score. So F1 score is basically the harmonic mean of my precision and recall. Now you might wonder, why are we taking harmonic mean and why not arithmetic mean or geometric mean? Consider a simple example of 1000 samples and a confusion matrix that looks like this. I have 85 true positives, 890 false positives, 15 false negatives and 10 true negatives. My accuracy is around 1%. My precision based on the formula here, which is TP upon TP plus FP, which is 85 upon 85 plus 890, is 1% again. But my recall, if you notice carefully, is 85 upon 85 plus 15, which is 85%. So if I use arithmetic mean, my F1 score would turn out to be 43%. But if you look at the confusion matrix, you can easily say that my model is not performing well, and 43% for such a model is not a realistic score. When we now look at arithmetic mean, it says 16%, which looks more of a realistic score for this given model rather than 43%. What F1 score does by you taking into consideration my harmonic mean is it punishes extreme values, and our desire of a machine learning model for an F1 score is the F1 score should be really high. In order to have a high F1 score, you need to have both a high precision as well as a recall value. Thank you so much for watching the video. Hope it was informative.